As with all commercial launches by U.S. companies, the Federal Aviation Administration will oversee the investigation into what went wrong with Saturday's Starship test. SpaceX blamed sluggishness at the FAA's Commercial Space Office for delays in launching the second Starship rocket. As it did after the April test flight, SpaceX will create a list of corrective actions to fix the problems observed on Saturday's launch. The FAA will approve the list and ensure SpaceX completes all of the actions relevant to public safety before issuing a new commercial launch license for the third Starship test flight. SpaceX launched its second Starship rocket flight on Saturday, with Elon Musk's company pushing development of the Mammoth vehicle past new milestones. Musk called the giant launcher a magnificent machine in a post on his social media site, X. Congrats to the teams who made progress on today's flight test. Starship flew for more than 7 minutes, successfully separating from its booster, before the rocket's onboard system intentionally destroyed the vehicle mid-flight. No people were on board the test flight. The fact that Starship launched on its second test flight without a scrub is a testament to how much work has gone into improving the vehicle and ground systems. We have lost the data from the second stage. What we do believe right now is that the automated flight termination system on the second stage appears to have triggered very late in the burn, John Innsbrucker, SpaceX principal integration engineer, said on the company's webcast. The flight termination system is a standard safety feature in rockets, as it destroys the vehicle if a problem arises or it flies off course. On SpaceX's webcast, Starship appears to have been detonated at an altitude of about 148 kilometers or about 485,000 feet. That is a little under half the altitude at which the International Space Station orbits the Earth. The intentional destruction of Starship represents a premature end to the flight test, as SpaceX planned to fly it most of the way around the Earth, before re-entering the atmosphere and splashing down off the coast of Kauai, Hawaii. An incredibly successful day, even though we did have a rapid and scheduled disassembly, both of the Super Heavy booster and the ship, SpaceX quality engineering manager Kate Tice said on the webcast. The Federal Aviation Administration confirmed it will oversee a mishap investigation into the flight, a standard regulatory procedure, before SpaceX can launch another Starship rocket. Mishap investigations are how the FAA analyzes the cause of a rocket launch failure, especially when a vehicle is destroyed. The regulator may give SpaceX corrective actions to complete before the company can receive a license for future Starship launches. The FAA said in a statement after the launch that no injuries or public property damage have been reported. As with all commercial launches by U.S. companies, the Federal Aviation Administration will oversee the investigation into what went wrong with Saturday's Starship test. Because both elements of the rocket were lost in Saturday's test, the FAA declared a mishap had occurred. The anomaly resulted in a loss of the vehicle. No injuries or public property damage have been reported, the FAA said. The FAA is responsible for ensuring commercial space launches don't endanger the public, assessing their environmental impacts, and making sure they comply with U.S. national security and foreign policy priorities. As it did after the April test flight, SpaceX will create a list of corrective actions to fix the problems observed on Saturday's launch. The FAA will approve the list and ensure SpaceX completes all of the actions relevant to public safety before issuing a new commercial launch license for the third Starship test flight. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson congratulated the company for making progress on today's flight test. Spaceflight is a bold adventure demanding a can-do spirit and daring innovation. Today's test is an opportunity to learn, then fly again, Nelson said in a social media post. The FAA cleared SpaceX for the second launch earlier this week. SpaceX first launched a full Starship rocket system in April. Although that flight did not reach space, it successfully achieved multiple historic firsts for an experimental rocket of unprecedented scale. The mid-air destruction of the rocket, as well as an investigation into damage caused back on the ground, triggered a regulatory review that spanned nearly 7 months. Lots of TPS tiles missing on S-25 today. It's important to note that SpaceX likely fully expected this to happen. On S-28, every tile was tested using a suction cup to verify adhesion. This was not performed on S-25 and as a result a large number of tiles along the ring weld lines fell off during flight. In other words, it's not as bad as it looks. For those wondering if today's Starship test flight was a success or a failure, the answer is both. There is no black or white answer to this. It was a success in that Starship performed better than during the first test flight. All 33 engines fired and the spacecraft survived separation. This is major progress. But Starship fell short of completing its mission, making almost a full lap of Earth, and splashing down into the Pacific Ocean, and exploded, or suffered a rapid and scheduled disassembly, as SpaceX likes to call it. For just over the next 5 minutes, all six Raptor engines on Ship 25 were firing nominally until SpaceX seemingly lost signal with the vehicle, possibly being the reason the automated flight termination system activated. This has yet to be confirmed by SpaceX. Overall, this was a huge improvement over the first test flight. SpaceX showed much greater reliability in the Raptor engines, with none of the 33 Raptor engines malfunctioning during the first stage burn, a flawless hot stage, and a very smooth Ship 25 burn until SpaceX lost signal. The launch pad seemingly fared much better this time around as well. Various live streams from the launch pad did not show giant chunks of debris flying after liftoff, which can help set SpaceX up for a much faster return to flight for Starship following their mishap investigation. How do you think SpaceX did the second time around? Vast improvements, or do you think they need a lot more work first? Goals for second flights. There were no people on board this attempt to reach space with Starship. The company's leadership has previously emphasized that SpaceX expects to fly hundreds of Starship missions before the rocket launches with any crew. SpaceX was looking to surpass the nearly 4-minute flight of the first launch, reach space with Saturday's attempt and demonstrate that improvements to its ground infrastructure mitigate the damage caused by the debut attempt. During the April launch, SpaceX lit only 30 of the 33 Raptor engines at the base of the Super Heavy booster. Other engines were lost mid-flight. Additionally, a communications problem led to an unexpected delay in triggering the rocket's autonomous flight termination system, which destroys the vehicle in the event it flies off course. SpaceX introduced upgrades to the launch pad infrastructure, as well as the design of the rocket itself for the second attempt. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.